Hi there, Serdar Yigalop here with InfoWorld at IDG. Today in Smart Python, we're going to look at the way lists in Python can be subdivided, what's called the slicing syntax, or slice notation. Lists aren't the only thing that can be sliced using the slice notation, by the way. Most any collection can be sliced. This includes things like tuples. But because we covered lists in the last video, they make a good segue into how slicing works generally. Now, last time we touched on the slicing syntax by way of how to get an individual element from a list. What slices let us do is take a range of items, or take the entire list in some manipulated fashion, such as in reverse. Slices use the same bracket notation we use to fetch a single element, but they use colons to indicate where to stop and start the slice. By default, we start at the first element and we stop at the end. So an empty colon expression like this just means take the whole thing. The start number used for a slice is easy enough. It's the index of the item you want to start the slice at. The second number is the index of the item where you want the slicing to stop. In other words, everything including and after the stop index is left out. In this example, we start at index 0 and stop in index 3. So we get the elements in indexes 0 through 2, which happen to be the numbers 1 through 3. A common beginner mistake people make with slicing is thinking the second number is how many elements to slice. It's not. It's an index to a specific point where you want the slicing to stop. Slices can also take a third number, the step indicator. This tells Python to take every nth element when slicing. By default, the step is 1. We step through every element. But if you set step to 2, then every other element will be taken. Set it to 3, and it's every third element, and so on. The step indicator is also useful because it lets us take reversed slices. If you set the step indicator to a negative number, then each step is taken backwards from the start point. This makes it easy to create a reversed list. Just use empty values for start and stop, since the default is beginning and end, whatever those may be, and use -1 for the step. Note that if you try to take a slice using a start point that's higher than the end point, without reversing your steps, it won't work. You'll just get an empty slice. An important thing to keep in mind about slicing, when you make a slice of anything, whether it's a list or any other sliceable structure in Python, you're making a new copy of that structure. You're making a new list. Slices aren't views into an existing collection. They construct an entirely new separate object. Now note that the objects inside the collection are still the same objects. Those aren't copied. But the list itself is created new when you make a slice. This is useful to know if you're working with extremely large collections of objects. If you have a list with thousands of items and you want to iterate over it in reverse order, don't use the ::-1 syntax, as this will create a whole new copy to no purpose. Instead, use the reversed built-in, which iterates over some collection in reverse order without making copies of anything. It's faster and it's more memory efficient. That's it for this episode of Smart Python. If you like this video, please leave a comment below. Don't forget to subscribe to the IDG Tech Talk channel on YouTube. And for more smart Python tips, be sure to follow us on Facebook, YouTube, and InfoWorld.com.